What's the difference between a Maltese and a Shih Tzu? Both Maltese and Shih Tzu can melt the heart of any animal lover. With their small bodies and cute faces, what's not to love? But as with most breeds, many dog lovers have a favorite. So, are you a Maltese person or a Shih Tzu person? We'll tell you all you need to know about these wonderful dogs so you can choose which one is the most suitable for your lifestyle and personality. Before we get into this, make sure to subscribe to our channel for more doggy tips and best practices. Leave a comment down below saying I subscribe and we will try our best to personally respond to your comments. Okay, so before we get into all the cute and juicy stuff, we're gonna take 1 minute to give you a snapshot of the origins of these breeds. Maltese breeds originated in Italy, particularly off the coast of Malta. Since Malta was colonized by the Phoenicians, that's probably more likely who brought them over. As they sailed and traded around the world, the Maltese dogs were most likely bartered for food or were used on the ships to help protect any food from rodents. Yuck! In Malta, Maltese were bred to be comforters, often seen sitting on the laps of many ladies. That's also most likely where you'll find them today, but we'll get to that. Let's take a look at the Shih Tzu breed. Did you know the Shih Tzu has roots in royal, yes, royal, Chinese history from over 2,000 years ago? Now, it's not fully known the exact origins of this breed, but evidence points to the breed being developed by Tibetan monks who were known to offer these pups as gifts to the Emperor of China. Quite impressive, if you ask me. Okay, so enough of the history, although it is quite interesting, but let's move on to the real reason you are watching this video, to learn about the similarities and differences between these two breeds. Appearance. Maltese and Shih Tzus are both small dogs and even referred to as toy breeds. It's the Shih Tzu's facial features and fur colors that distinguish it from the Maltese. Shih Tzus have a squished face and floppy ears. It is slightly longer than it is tall, has a sturdy body, a good-sized head, a short muzzle, and prominent eyes. The elegant Maltese is famous for its silky white hair covering its body, but there is a lot more to the Maltese than just his coat. Maltese have a slightly rounded skull, black nose, drop ears, dark alert eyes, short straight legs, and a graceful tail. Nothing is cuter than having your pup cuddle you as you take a stroll. This is the perfect pet carrier hoodie for your little ball of fluff. Get your hoodie pet pouch sweatshirt now. Both Maltese and Shih Tzus are popular choices for those looking for small and friendly dogs. But how do they compare in size? When looking at size, remember that males typically tend to be larger than females, and height is measured at the tallest point on the body, the shoulder blades, not the head. Both male and female Shih Tzus are around 10 inches in height and weigh between 9 and 16 pounds. They have a lifespan of 14 to 15 years old. Male Maltese are around 8 to 10 inches tall at the shoulder, while females are slightly shorter at 8 to 9 inches tall. They have a lifespan of 12 to 15 years. The compact Maltese should weigh no more than 7 pounds at maturity, but generally stays between 4 to 6 pounds. Generally, the Shih Tzu is a slightly larger dog than the Maltese. So what about coat color? Good question! Shih Tzus have a double coat and are covered with luxurious, long, straight hair. Their coat colors can vary from all black to black and white, gray and white, or red and white. Darker pigment is often preferred and seen around the eyes, nose, and throughout the body. On the other hand, Maltese came in many colors years ago, but these days, they are always white. If you like what you see so far, subscribe and give us a like. Hit the notification bell so you're notified anytime we upload. Temperament. The words we would use to describe both the Shih Tzu and the Maltese are generally the same: loving, happy, and friendly. Shih Tzus have a perky and happy temperament. They're lively and super friendly, making them a great dog if you have other pets in the house. They're great for all ages, friendly with children, and wonderful companions for seniors. Maltese breeds are sweet, intelligent dogs who are devoted to their owners, and as one of the smallest of the toy breeds, he's well suited for apartment or condo living. The Maltese has a lively personality and assumes that everyone they meet, human or animal, is a friend. Sweet and cute, they're widely known for always getting their way, even with people who have no intention of spoiling them. Maltese enjoy a regular walk or playing outside. Since they are active indoors and don't require a great deal of exercise, it doesn't take a lot of effort to keep them in good shape. Shih Tzus are attention seekers and have a big desire to always be around people, whether that's having a nice snuggle on the couch or going out for a walk. This is not a bad thing unless you're not into clingy, loyal dogs. The thing is, they just love having company, another reason why they make such great pets for seniors since they are home more often. If you're a coffee or tea drinker, this mug is for you. It's so adorable, especially for the Shih Tzu lover. It has a classy look to it and should bring a smile to your face. Although Maltese look delicate and maybe a bit posh, they can have a lot of energy. Maltese require a lot of human attention as they have been bred to be companion dogs and could suffer from separation anxiety if left alone for too long. When they feel stressed, they can bark frequently and become destructive. Shih Tzus are generally quiet dogs, but do have the tendency to bark, wheeze, and snore. They're easy to live with and don't require too much exercise, although they would benefit from daily walks to keep them at a good weight. They can become obese quickly if overfed or given too many yummy treats. Shih Tzus are your loyalist companions and thrive on your company. Don't expect them to be good guard dogs. They're so friendly that they would even let a stranger into your home and would then probably just follow them around too. On the total opposite side, the Maltese is responsive to his environment and makes an effective watchdog. Don't mess with that little ball of fur. Which one is easier to train? Shih Tzus enjoy learning tricks and training because it makes them the center of attention, which we all know they love. Both Shih Tzus and Maltese have been known to be difficult to house train. Crate training both of them will help with house training and gives them their own little place to rest when you're not home. If you need more tips on how to crate train, we created a video all about how to crate train your new puppy. Check it out by clicking the link in the description below. Since Maltese are very people-oriented, they typically do well with training in response to positive reinforcements such as food rewards, praise, and play. Maltese are generally easier to train than Shih Tzus as they excel in the areas of being therapy dog and competitor dogs like agility, obedience, rally, and tracking. Although Shih Tzus and Maltese are naturally friendly dogs, they both need early training and socialization to keep them from being too timid around others. These vibrant color pillowcases make the cutest accessory to your home. They also come in a variety of dog breeds to suit your decor needs or to gift to a friend. Very chic and very cute. Grooming and shedding. When it comes to grooming a Shih Tzu, you're in for some serious dedication and work. But again, it all depends on your preferences. If you desire to keep their long coat looking stellar, they require weekly baths and oiling of the coat. Daily brushing is important to protect its coat from anything getting into it and from matting. If you prefer to keep the coat short, prepare for grooming appointments every 6 to 8 weeks. Some good news for you, Shih Tzus overall are a low shedding dog breed. One of the main reasons for this is because they have a top coat made up of hair rather than fur. Maltese ranks similar with Shih Tzu being a low shedding dog. Straight and thick, the coat can reach all the way to the floor. But he doesn't have an undercoat. The Maltese sheds very little and is therefore considered a hypoallergenic breed. On the downside, Maltese coats mat easily and become dirty. In addition, Maltese are prone to unsightly tear stains on their faces. Daily brushing and combing of your Maltese coat will prevent mats and keep them nice and clean. Although Maltese have a beautiful coat, it comes with maintenance. They can easily become dirty and usually must be bathed weekly. If you're in the market for a sneeze-free friend, rest assured that both Maltese and Shih Tzu are the perfect choice. health problems. Due to its short muzzle, you will want to avoid exercising a Shih Tzu in hot, humid weather. Shih Tzus are prone to heat strokes, so you'll want to keep them well hydrated and be aware of how long you're walking them for when the temperature is very high. Maltese are prone to chills, especially if they are damp or walking in damp areas, so you'll want to protect them in rainy and cold weather. If your Maltese has long hair, he can get sunburn on the skin where the hair is parted on the back of his body. Talk about love! This Sherpa throw is the softest and comfiest blanket to snuggle in with your pup. It's a high-quality throw repping Maltese or Shih Tzu doggies. Get yours today! Weird habits. Okay, don't get too grossed out here, but the Shih Tzu is one of those dog breeds that are prone to eat its own or another animal's feces. All it requires is a little bit more attention on your part to clean up its poop right away. Maltese are not good beach or summer dogs. They're prone to sunburn. Ouch! Both Shih Tzus and Maltese are very similar and rank high on many dog owners' lists. They are lovable, easy to live with, and are super cute and friendly. The Shih Tzu is a gentle, affectionate dog who thrives on love. It's low maintenance and doesn't require a lot of strenuous activity. He's up for a daily walk only if you are. They are low shedding, meaning cleanup is easy. Shih Tzus are very quiet dogs and faithful companions. They're great with children and people of all ages. Shih Tzus were bred to be companions, and that's exactly what they desire to do. Love on you. Maltese are the perfect cuddle buddies and enjoy their fair share of snuggles. These cute lap dogs are, well, sized to fit on your lap. They're calm and they don't weigh too much, making them perfect snuggle buddies. Since they are a very delicate breed, they're not recommended for young children. They can be prone to accidents and can be easily injured. They are a super lovable breed and won't need too much extra space, except in your heart, of course. How do you choose between a Labrador Retriever or a Golden Retriever? They're super similar, sharing intelligence, high energy levels, and that goofy personality that dog lovers can't get enough of. We know the decision can be hard, so we want to help you. To help you make an informed decision about your future family pet, we've put together an easy guide about these two popular breeds. Enjoy the simple breakdown of Golden Retriever versus Labrador Retriever as we examine the similarities and differences that make these doggies unique. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you're new to our channel and you like it, please subscribe.